Hello and welcome to the course. In today's lecture, we will learn about having clause in SQL and we will try to get the same result in DAX. For this, I am using the same query that we have written in the last lecture to get the total sum for the product category, subcategory, product name and color columns by using group by. So I need to know the total transaction for each product. For this, I need to write here total sales transactions. And here I have to write count function. And instead of sales amount, we will write here, there is order date key. And that's it. We just need to execute. And here you can see we are getting all the transaction for the relevant product under different categories and subcategories. And we are getting 130 rows, and these are the total transactions. And now we need to use having clause. We will use the same aggregation count. So count s dot order key is greater than 1000. We just need to execute it. So here you can see we are getting every sale transaction is greater than 1000. So we are getting total 15 rows. So we need to get the same result in DAX. So how we can perform having clause? So let's go to the DAX studio. And here I have again copy paste this. In the last lecture, we have written this DAX expression that contain summarize, select column, and then we are using natural inner join to interlink different tables, and we got this sum x and everything. So what we need to do is we just need to use here count x, and the first column is the table name, and the second here we need to write here order date key. So that's it. So let's run this. And here you can see, we also need to change, maybe it's all up to you if you want to change the column name. So it's like a sales transactions. So if I run here, you can see the column name is sales transaction. And here we can see all the count of all the transactions for the relevant products. And we are getting 130 rows. So how to apply having clause here? As we are getting this whole DAX expression is giving us one table, and this is the table that contain 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 columns and some underlying data. So what we need to do, we need to apply filter now. So here we can write one filter. And the filter needs, the first parameter that is required for the filter function is table. And this whole stuff is one table. And we need to write here comma, and the filtering criteria will be, this is the new column, sales underscore transaction. We just need to copy. And here we can write under brackets, we can write sales transactions is greater than 1000, and then we need to close it. So now we have combined filter, summarize, select column, natural inner join, and if I try to click run, and here you can see we are getting all the sales transactions for all the products that are greater than 1000. And here you can see we are getting 15 rows. So Now we are getting identical result that we have got here in the SQL. So this is how you can achieve having clause and group by in SQL and in parallel with DAX.